In this how-to video, we'll cover the basics of wiring and setting up one of Automation Direct's advanced area sensors from the brand Micro Detectors. I'm currently using the model number shown, CX0E1RP-10-016V. These come as a pair with an emitter and a receiver. The Micro Detector area sensors we sell at Automation Direct all require connecting cable. Make sure you select the correct cable with correct number of pinouts in either a straight or a 90-degree connector. The sensors I'm using require a 4-pin 12mm connector cable for the emitter and a 5-pin 12mm connector cable for the receiver. I'm using the part numbers listed on the screen. Keep in mind, we sell many cables that will work depending on your application and environment. We have 90-degree connectors, straight connectors, harsh environment insulation, shielded cables, and they all come in many different lengths. Just make sure you select the correct number of poles or pins for your sensor. If you have questions, use a multimeter and check the pin out or call our free technical support here at Automation Direct. I follow the wiring diagrams for these sensors. It can be found in the documentation that comes with the sensor, or you can find it on our website. The emitter has four connections. Brown for positive voltage and blue for negative voltage are common to power the sensor. Black should be connected to a switcher device to allow for gross or fine teach functions. Last, white should be connected to the gray wire on the receiver. Now let's wire the receiver. The receiver has five connections. Brown for positive voltage and blue for negative voltage or common to power the sensor. The black wire on the receiver should be connected to your output device and wired as PNP. In this example, I have the black wire connected to the positive input on a Verma stack light that we sell here at Automation Direct. Make sure you check the specs of your device. I'm using an LED indicator because the incandescent light required more current than the sensor supplied, so we would not see an indication. Next is the white wire. It should be wired to a switcher device to select normally open or normally closed outputs. Last, gray should be connected to the white wire on the emitter. Now that our emitter and receiver are both wired, we need to check for alignment. The user manual describes how to properly align the emitter and receiver and what errors to detect if they are out of alignment. The manual also explains which LEDs you will see if your system is not wired properly. We can now power the sensors and check for operation. Once we power up, there is a time delay or time delay before availability. Once powered up and ready, we can set up the sensor. When the sensor is first powered up, we should only see a blue LED on the receiver and a yellow and green LED on the emitter. Right now, we have no power applied to the normally open, normally closed feature, so the sensor defaults to normally open, meaning that there is no output until the sensor detects a part. As you can see, when the sensor detects my screwdriver, our Verma stack light green light turns on, and I also see a yellow and red LED indication in the receiver. Making changes to the normally open, normally closed only takes place on power up. If I attempt to change the setup after the sensor is powered up, nothing will change. I must power down, select normally closed, and repower the system, and now my green stack light stays on, and I also see a blue and yellow LED in the receiver when no part is detected. Once a part is detected, the green stack light turns off and we see a blue and red LED in the receiver. Now let's discuss the teach function. This was where we wired the black wire on the emitter to a switch with either positive or negative input in the sensor. Teach allows us to adjust for fine or gross sensing. As you see, when I first select fine or gross, the yellow LEDs on the emitter will blink until the sensor has calibrated. Let's discuss quickly what fine and gross settings are. Gross teach is used to detect opaque objects and semi-transparent objects with textured or corrugated surfaces. Fine teach is used when detecting small objects or transparent, smooth objects like glass. how you set up your sensors will be determined on your environment and what type of objects you're detecting. Now our sensors are mounted, wired, set up, aligned, and programmed, and is ready to start detecting product. Now, what should we detect? I hope this how-to video was useful. Please follow us to other how-to videos on our micro detector area sensors. Thanks, and have a great day. If you have any questions about using our sensors, please contact Automation Direct's free award-winning technical support team during regular business hours. They will be happy to help. Click on this short video to learn more about Automation Direct support options, and click here to learn more or see more videos on sensor products. And be sure to click here to subscribe to our YouTube channel to be notified of new videos.